for you. Like I just said, is a key. May that obedience open doors for you in the name of Jesus. May your choice to obey Jesus break through barriers of ancestral curses in the mighty name of Jesus. Because you obey, may the fire of God come and rest on you today and scatter bondage, the spirit of bondage around you in the mighty name of Jesus. But you have to choose to obey. Receive your key. The key to freedom. Let your obedience open the way for you. Things that have been stuck for years or generations, may they be opened right now in Jesus' name. Take it. Take it. It's yours. Jesus is a giver. He's a giver. For God so loved the world that he gave. God wants to give. If you ask anything, 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 this is your time to ask anything. Lord Jesus, that bondage, that fear, that pain, whatever has been there, you know, distracting you, obstructing you, hindering you, this is the time. Lord Jesus, I receive the key. I receive the key. I choose to obey you. I choose to obey your word. I know these are ancient words. You told Moses to write it down, and it's still the same word today. I receive you, and I obey you, and I receive the reward of obedience. In Jesus' name, amen. So as we wait, let us wait in expectation, in anticipation. You know what you are waiting for. Like I said, we know what the first disciples did not know. Ask for increase. Ask for fresh anointing, more anointing. Ask for increase. Fresh oil. Carry the fire and carry extra oil. Ask the Holy Spirit, set me on fire. Let that flame be on me. Set me on fire. So that I can be purified to go to Jesus to make acceptable offerings to my God. I want to be able to bring God an offering that is acceptable, according to what we just read in Malachi. We will receive a reward that is beyond what money can do for you. Eternal life, peace even while you live here, freedom from bondage, limitations are broken. Ask and you shall receive. Anything, Jesus says, and I will do, once you are his friend, once you are obedient to his commandments. We have to be expectant because we know the magnitude of what we are supposed to receive. You know what is coming. Don't waste your time this week. It is the feast this week, like I said at the beginning, is when the Jewish people celebrate the feast of weeks. It's also called Feast of Harvest or Feast of First Fruit or Feast of Ingathering. That this is the time that the Lord gathers unto himself. He's the Lord of the harvest, like Jesus said in the Gospel of John. He gathers his people. On Pentecost, Peter preached with the fire of God on him, and 3,000 people were gathered unto the Lord. 3,000 people were gathered in. So the Feast of Weeks is the Feast of Ingathering. God wants to gather his people. He wants to bring them back home. He wants you to be the home that he dwells in. Don't bother about the other mountains of many peaks that are envious of you. You are the mountain. where God desires to dwell in.
Lord, I want to see your face. I want to know your ways. I want to touch your grace so I can live your days.